What's up, Crypto Universe? You're watching Rock the Block Live Daily News. This episode was brought to you by OneChain, the world's first cross-chain solution for the financial infrastructure. First up on headline news in the FUDIP and FOMON category, we have quite a bit to talk about that today. Nebulous released the NAS Nano version 2.2.0 and started the NAS token swap. From ERC20 tokens to mainnet NAS token, and this have started on the 26th of September. So far, no hiccups from the technical side. Everything is going as planned. There will be no further extension on the swapping deadline. So what's important to note is that if you have not swapped your tokens, you have until the 10th of October to do so, because after that, the Nebulous team will no longer be supporting the ERC20 version of the token. So if you're still holding onto your NAS tokens, do the swap now or risk losing all of them. A Puerto Rican startup bank is struggling to survive, and this will have a major impact on the crypto scene. Why? Noble Bank is trying hard to stay afloat and is currently looking for funding. The bank has a large chunk of asset coming from Tether's US dollars and has reached out to one large shareholder of the stablecoin in hopes of getting a cash lifeline. However, the solicitation has been rejected. Experts say that Noble Bank has just a few days to survive and they are desperate. Meanwhile, Tether themselves have troubles of its own. A top person at a major trading crypto desk has stated that one counterparty has been trying to offload tens of millions of Tether without successfully finding a counterparty. And this comes at a time where there are more and more stable coins coming into the market, threatening to unseat USDT or Tether as the dominant stable coin player. Two of these other new dollar-backed stablecoins are from Gemini and Paxos. These two new coins have the added benefit of being audited and regulated by the New York Department of Financial Services, while USD Tether isn't. And for the longest time, many people have wondered, are there actually US dollars in the vault backing these Tethers because they aren't audited and it's their words against ours, right? So who do you believe, an auditor account or someone who just promises you that they have US dollar in the vault, but actually they don't? Sounds quite familiar, wouldn't you think, where a particular body in the financial world has stated that they have bank or gold bars in the vault, but no one really knows, and that particular vault has not been audited for years. Also, with the recent shutdown of one broker, which is actually a lesser known crypto exchange, centralized exchanges are becoming increasingly susceptible to external risk like regulations and manipulations. So there is a growing belief that a secured, no-frills decentralized exchange is the way to go forward in the crypto world. Despite being one of the relatively new kid on the block in the world of exchanges, Binance have quickly risen up the leaderboard to be one of the most popular exchanges, centralized exchanges in the crypto world today. Although Binance right now is a centralized exchange with tens of millions of users having an account on Binance, an interview with CZ recently has stated that he is moving towards decentralized exchange. In the interview, and I quote, "I believe that decentralized exchanges are the future. I don't know when the future will come. I think that we are at an early stage for that. I don't know if it will be a year, 2 years, 3 years or five, but we have to be ready for it. We being Binance, are now actively investing our efforts and time into this space." Well, if you want to find out more about what he said about exchanges and the future of exchanges, whether it's centralized or decentralized exchanges, click on the link below and hop on straight to the interview with CZ. In the next category, media size, the regulators. Malta, blockchain island. The Maltese government is enacting the cryptocurrency and blockchain regulation, moving towards its goal to become the global hub for blockchain-inspired innovations. While other countries around the globe is either cracking down on cryptocurrency or ICO projects, or taking just a wait-and-see attitude, the Mediterranean island country and the smallest member of the European Union is creating a comfortable regulatory environment for the newly born industry. In July, the Maltese government approved three bills and provided a regulatory framework for the cryptocurrency and blockchain industry. which has been approved and will come into effect as early as November 1st, 2018, this year. You can check out the link in the description below if you're interested in what the bill or the details of the bills are. The announcement coincides with the upcoming Malta Blockchain Summit, which is becoming the first official platform to promote blockchain and cryptocurrency products in Malta. Malta Blockchain Summit CEO Amon Poulos commented on the announcement. "We are delighted that the timing coincides so perfectly. We have always said that we are here to support the conscious efforts being made at the national level to make Malta the primary jurisdiction for blockchain and DLT. We are hoping that Malta Blockchain Summit will serve as a showcase for the ecosystem and will justify the efforts made by the Maltese government on a legislative front. This is a great opportunity for stakeholders and all 5,000 delegates attending the event." Another good news for the blockchain community, Canadian crypto firm Coinsquare is bringing fiat-based financial world a little bit closer to cryptocurrency world. Coinsquare will be the first crypto company out of Canada to secure a partnership with one of Canadian's 5 top banks. The partnership will help in streamlining the processes of withdrawing and depositing funds for the users. Cold Diamond Coinsquare CEO commented on the achievement, saying, "This is a tremendous boost not only for Coinsquare, but for the entire Canadian cryptocurrency industry. At Coinsquare, our motto has always been to do digital currency right." Coinsquare allows users to trade in Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other popular tokens, and also they are the world's first exchange to be releasing a consolidated financial statement audit. Chinese Bitcoin tycoon Li Xiaolai will no longer be investing in any blockchain projects. In a statement released on Weibo Post, he states that from this day on, Li Xiaolai personally will not invest in any projects, whether it's blockchain or early stage. So if you see any Li Xiaolai associated with any project, just ignore it. He went on to say that he planned to spend the next several years to contemplate on a career change. Li is the founder of Beijing-based Capital Bitfund and one of the largest Bitcoin holders in China. His sudden announcement has stirred sentiments in the local crypto community. "As one of the largest Bitcoin holders in China, his announcement has stirred a little bit of controversy in the Chinese market. Mr. Li Xiaolai's value have been severely underrated," said one of his followers. While there were several supportive comments from his followers, others remain doubtful. True institutions. Though Li has claimed that he will not be personally involved in investing, others felt that he might do so through other institutions or investment funds. Earlier this year, Li stepped down as the managing partner of the $1 billion Hangzhou Xiang'an blockchain fund after a series of accusations made against him. Most notable of this is a feud with venture capitalist Chen Weixing. Chen previously openly called Li a tumor in the Chinese cryptocurrency industry and later accused Li of owing a group of investors 30,000 bitcoins which he had collected in 2013 for an investment fund. Not long after, Li found himself again knee-deep in controversy as a 50-minute recording of his advice to various investors surfaced. In that recording, Li was going around the crypto circle giving advice on how to cut leaks, a reference to new investors entering the market that get harvested by bigger players. In what must be one of the saddest news that most of you probably can relate to, crypto asset investment firm Block Tower CEO Ari Paul has lost 99.73% of his $1 million Bitcoin price bet as the 2018 bear market claims fresh victims. That's a total of 275 BTC worth of pain. The eye-watering figure surfaced on social media on September 27. You remember the price of Bitcoin last year in December and January? It was going up and up and everyone was bullish about Bitcoin price. Well, Paul has forecasted that in 2018 December, Bitcoin price will rise to $50,000. So back then in December 2017, he bought Bitcoin of Ledger X for about $3,600. And right now, as the price has crashed to rock bottom at $6,000 holding a very strong support, what Paul will get back from his initial investment would just be $10 for each of his placements. Now, that is a lot of money lost, and I'm sure many of you can feel his pain. How many of you bought in during the December period and is now feeling the burn? Well, all I can say is, if you're going to sell it at 99% loss, you might as well just hold it in and consider it a loss already. And who knows, in a few years' time, you might be pleasantly surprised. Now, that's all the news I have for you today. My name is Eugene Tate, giving you the advice on what goes on in the cryptocurrency universe. Share this video with all your friends. Don't leave anyone behind. Well, I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Nailed that, bitch.